Google that.
Money maker, take that money maker. Hey Mo,
phone one time.
Somebody in there put some clips, but it was like no name.
212.
Oh, you talking? We
212. I'm gonna put that thing on the Tito's zone right there.
Yeah. That's the only one I know. That I be putting up all the time. You sure it wasn't me? Was it me to put it up?
No.
Hey, T, you know, what's up, John Bell?
Past,
one of the most powerful interviews I ever did, man, was my main man, Jay Bell. John Bell Jr. He got a book coming out, man. This guy's amazing, Tommy.
Really?
Yeah, you got to, we got to bring him up to Soul World. He's amazing, man. He got a story to tell, too, man. So, that's what it do, man. We going to go on live in a minute, y'all. What's up, cousin Rick? Down Carolina, man. You remember Rick? My cousin, Big Rick? Yeah, what's up, Rick? I love you, man. No, that's my cousin, Rick. Rick named after him. That's Big Rick. Rick, Little Rick.
Oh.
Hey, appreciate you, Raul. I'm you know, hey, look, I got go-go on my back right now, man. You know how I'm doing, man. I'm just doing what I do, baby. Shouts out to Wincy, y'all. Wincy, a happy birthday, y'all. Cliff Jones, a happy birthday. My man, Brandley Finley, gonna call in, too. So that's how we doing it. That's how we get it in, man. So we're going to start this thing off in a minute. We're going to go live on the air. The whole world watching. The whole world is waiting on me as they do. Brandon's in Germany right now, man. And it's a pub out there in Cologne, Germany, man. Called Lucille's. They watch us each and every Tuesday faithfully, man. It's like 60 of them, Tom.
Really?
Yeah, big screen, man. Real big screen, man. We live here, Ron?
Yeah.
Oh, we live here. Ain't no music number. Look, y'all. I'll be Congo by. Congo Hour, 8 to 10 p.m. each and every Tuesday, man. ElikeMedia.net, powered by LiveMusicForYou.com. 240-455-5934 is the number if you want to call in and holler at. I got celebrities around the table already, man. We got my main man, KC from the legendary Class Band is up in the building. He got a project going on. We got Juan Chapman up in here, man. Just one of the most treasures in go-go right now. He supports us in each and everything we do. DJ Rick on the ones and twos. Ron's on the engineering point. But we're going to start off. Ladies and gentlemen, this guy to the left of me and to the right of y'all, if y'all looking the whole world, is not only my best friend, but my god brother. I was his best man at his wedding. He was my best man at my wedding. I met my wife actually at his wedding.
Wow.
So y'all already know how we go, man. This guy's the VP of Soul World Entertainment, the biggest conglomerate in the DMV right now. They handle all the Braxton's business, Genuine, Tank. They're responsible for Drew Hill. They're responsible for a whole lot of things, man. If you walk into their office, all you see is platinum plaques everywhere. Cliff Jones, the big bro, is the CEO. So y'all put your hands together and welcome the vice president of Soul World Entertainment. Mr. Tommy Reed is in the building right now.
Thank you,
Pete.
I appreciate that, man.
Hey, bro, this, what's so funny about this right now? I'm interviewing my best friend, right? It's like, okay, where do I start at with this dude, man? It's like, we together all the time, right? We used to live together. I mean, this is like, you know, my brother.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? First of all, let me commend you, bruh, you and Cliff, first of all, for all the events that be after the Wizards games, y'all, that y'all see, these are the guys that put that on. So give them a round of applause, man.
Appreciate that.
Along with Monumental Sports. You guys, man, y'all just had BBD there, Mom and Sap there, Seek and Find. Who else did y'all have up there?
Johnny Gill, Tank.
And these guys handle all Tank's business, too. How do you guys even find time for yourselves? Because you guys are so busy all the time.
Yeah, man. I mean, it's crazy, man. I mean, you know, when you're in this business, man, and you love it at heart.
Right.
Then, you know, you do it like a workhorse, man.
Yeah.
You know, you constantly getting phone calls. You know, constantly getting emails. And outside of us doing the celebrity aspect on a professional level, then, you know, we get stuff from all over the world, man. From artists and...
Yes, you know, you do.
And that's included even working on the TV side. So it's crazy, man.
Yeah, I mean, I'm up there the other day, Casey, and Juan. I'm just chilling in the office, you know, with them. I am the official AR, too.
Oh.
They laughing at me. But, you know, phone rings, right?
Right.
You know. It's Fred Hammond on the speakerphone.
Right.
You know, you know, Tyrese called. I mean,
it's like God calling.
It's like, I'm like, these dudes, you know. But the thing about it is, you know, I've been around, you know, celebrities all my life. It's nothing. But at the same time, when you hear celebrities on the other end of the line, just the way they respect these guys and look to them, you know, for advice, you know, that's crazy, man.
Yeah, I mean, it is crazy, man. But, you know, my partner, Cliff, who's the CEO of Soul World, you know, he has a very extensive background.
And for those of y'all who don't know, Cliff is the one that sung probably the most famous gospel song ever, Be Encouraged.
Right.
And that's Cliff that sung that song.
He sung my mother's funeral last year. Yeah, Cliff.
Wow,
yeah.
He did?
Wow.
Yeah, he did. Last February, yeah, he sung my mother.
That was your mom? I remember that he was going to sing it.
You remember him saying that?
Yeah.
Down the church in the southeast. I don't know the name of the church. Right on.
You remember that, Tommy?
Yeah.
That's my mother. Yeah. My mother.
Wow, Casey.
30-year cancer
survivor.
Yes, sir.
Wow.
Yeah, pick that mic up. You ain't no stranger to it.
Oh, yeah. 30-year cancer survivor.
Looking clean as the board of hell.
Come on, man.
Wow, but, you know, people don't understand that the background associated with Soul World is extensive. I mean, Cliff has been around. I mean, good gracious, he started out with Gene Griffin, which a lot of people, the youngest probably don't really know Gene Griffin's history.
The first Suge Knight.
Right, they probably don't know his history, but Cliff was basically under his, you know, tutelage or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how he learned, you know, because he was on tour.
With Michael Jackson.
Cliff was extensive and all that. So over the years, man, it progressed. So.
And he was the one, if y'all don't know, back in the day, remember when Puffy came here? With Subtle Thoughts and all them, and got Puffy and Black Rob and all those. Remember that show? That was them that did that.
Out of everything that we do, we always trying to plug Go-Go.
And I ain't going to let the cat out the bag, but it's something that's coming up. It's all I'm going to say to y'all, man. It's going to be the biggest thing that Go-Go has ever seen.
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
It's going to be the biggest
thing. Yeah. You know. In the Congo, believe me, it's a real big pot.
Once it gets announced, then we'll come on the show. And we'll have Cliff on the show, and then we'll have, you know, the real legendary Go-Go people. Because the youngins really don't know.
You got to hip them.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And they really don't know the founders of this Go-Go music.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And we got to get to a point where these youngins have to respect.
That's why I do what I do.
Of this Go-Go music.
Who this is? Tony. Oh, what's up, Block?
So, you know.
Hey, your boy C. Newman said, what's up, Tom?
Hey, what's
up, Shantae Richard. Hey, baby. Hey, Walt. Jerry. What's up, Ice? Hey, Angie. I love you, baby. JC in Munich, Germany. Kev Bella. Oh, Kev. Washington, Florida. Hey, baby. Cubs. All right. Back to you, Tom.
Yeah. But, you know, it's, man, all I can say is that we've been blessed to be able to do the things that we do.
Yeah.
And be around the people that we're around, especially when we did the Backyard.
That show was crazy.
Horizon Center.
They had Backyard and they had Team Familiar at the Horizon Center.
That was a tremendous aspect of the Go-Go scene right now for 2017, because Go-Go had just got such a bad rap over the years.
Yeah.
So Cliff was like, "Look, man, let's go down here and talk to these people, man, and see if we could let's bring in two bands to start out." To try it out, and the Horizon Center said, "Okay, let's see what the local band."
And you had 11,000 people.
I think that was the beginning, because a lot of city dignitaries was there. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of people got real go-go, and then they say, "Okay, this is not, you know, it was no fights going on, or none of that. It was just a wonderful event, man." Mm-hmm. I think that. It's changing a lot of the attitude that people had against Go-Go.
Right.
So now, from that moment, we're going to take it up a notch.
That's all we're going to say. Hmm? You can jive like weed in between.
We can't give too much. But we just got to keep moving forward, man, and be positive, you know, and just move forward, man.
God is good, man.
Like I said, don't talk about it, do it, right?
That's right.
Yeah. Don't talk about it, be about it. Yeah. You understand me? 8, 10 p.m. each and every Tuesday. That's the Hobby Con guy. The show to save go-go. I'm not saying that. I'm just telling what people are saying to me. You know what I'm saying? Sitting here with Riding Shotgun with my main man, my partner, Tommy Reeve, VP of the Soulware Entertainment Group, along with Cliff Jones, the CEO. Tommy, man, it's so to me, it's so crazy because, like, a lot of times, I I'm in the office, in the studio with you guys, right? And people, I be telling people, you know, what be going on. Man, everybody be calling that joint, man. Anytime Tyrese gonna put out an APB on Cliff Jones on Twitter saying, if anybody knows where Cliff Jones is, please contact him. And flew him out to L.A. the next day because he needed help on his album.
Yeah.
Wow. The stage on and all that. Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, because Cliff is an excellent vocal coach. So yeah. A lot of people understand, like, I mean, a lot of people didn't even know he sang.
And that's crazy. And then he out there, all of a sudden, Will from Black Eyed Peas. Oh, he's here? Oh, we need his help, too.
Yeah, it's been crazy, man. But then outside of just the music aspect,
yeah,
you know, Cliff wanted to get into TV. And, you know, basically when he say, I want to do something,
he doesn't.
Sometimes look at him and be like, man, you can't do that. You crazy. He said, okay. Next thing you know, man, hey, we in the Braxtons. And
yeah.
We dealing with the networks. And, you know, it's just moving forward, man. We did Tracy's album here in the DMV, which did excellent. I think her album, Highest Rank, I think was 16 on Billboard. The single went number one at one point on Billboard on Heatseekers chart. So
and shout out to Dave too, man. Producer extraordinaire.
It's been good, man. It's been good.
You know, and their nucleus is Seven Sons of Soul. They have a gospel group too. So
yeah,
Junior, shout out to Dave Junior. These guys, and Cliff's group is called Seven Sons of Soul, for you guys who don't know. These guys have been in every last Tyler Perry movie, their songs. That's crazy, right? Tyler Perry always comes back and get this group. The song, Clap Your Hands If You Love the Lord, I'll Be Praying for You. Just numerous hits, like that scene when Jill Scott was driving in the snow, and that song came on, Clap Your Hands If You Love the Lord. That's Seven Sons of Soul. Checks. Ching, 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 ching.
Yeah.
You know, so let's give Tommy Reed and Cliff Jones a round of applause again, too, because they are true DC treasures. True DC treasures, man. We have to start acknowledging our own, because they're doing, like, big things, worldwide things, and a lot of things are swept under the rug because you got a lot of haterism in this city, man. And people don't realize, you know, until we, you know, unify and get together, we can make so much progress. So once again, man, for Tommy Reed, Soulware Entertainment, man. Interview with my brother, man. That's crazy.
That's right,
man. Good God Almighty. Next up to bat, man, we're going to pass the mic over to my main man, Juan. What's up, man? Give him that mic, KC, man. Give my brother the mic, man. This dude right here, let me say a few things about this dude. This dude, okay, you have supporters in Go-Go. You have brothers in Go-Go. You have true treasures in Go-Go. But this guy is... always supportive, unbiased. There's a support. He just came in here with a half gallon of Tito's, y'all.
Ooh, God.
This guy, when he comes to the Conga Hour, always bringing something, always respectful. I don't consider him a friend. I consider him one of my brothers. And without further ado, everybody, put your hands together for Juan Chappas in the build, man. And he playing drums now, man. You took a dog.
I saw you playing drums, Juan.
That's what's up, man. What you?
It's like practice.
I'm learning.
No, you doing it, dog.
Track. He had a click track going.
Hey, Slim, you know, you sound good, dog.
Appreciate it, brother. I'm learning.
Wow, man.
Playing on time and everything.
Let me ask you a question, bro. I mean, why so much passion, man, and dedication towards our genre, man? What stimulates that in you, bro?
Well, it starts with you have to understand the respect for what you all do. And being a musician, sure, there, you know, you develop the passion, skill, but there's a lot of hard work involved in that.
Yes,
and
sir.
I think a lot of people don't understand that. You know, when you come to a show, that's the finished product. But the hard work behind the scenes, man, so many people aren't even aware of that. what you all do. You know, as you know, we've discussed in the past, man, you know, something's got to be done about this, how the business have changed, whereas if a band has a show, they got to spend $400 or $500 for sound before they even play.
Right. Yeah,
all these things, man, we got to do something to fix that, man. It's, I mean, you haven't even played yet and you in debt, but you doing something for the people.
Wow.
That, you know, something wrong with that.
Yes, sir.
We have to fix that.
Talk that.
We have to fix that. There's no doubt about that. You know, you all come in and you put your time, hard work, and effort. And when you get out on that stage, you see it each and every night. You know, you rise up to, hey, the rehearsals, what you've done. And you got to be compensated for that. You know, go-go is no different from any other genre of music, and you out and it's time to do things right. Yeah. But you know what?
Preach,
what
boy.
You said. It takes a collaborative effort, it's more than sitting around talking. See, we can't sit here and have unequal numbers where one band gets their numbers and I'm satisfied.
Right.
That's the band that can help all.
Right.
But it got to be in your heart to do that.
Right.
That's very important, man, that you work together. Man, when they say strength is in numbers.
Come on, man.
Huh?
Yeah.
Strength is in numbers. You get people on the same page, man. It ain't about nobody being in charge, nobody getting more than the next one or whatever. It's togetherness, man.
And you know what? And you also, you're right, and you also got to understand, too, that you're a brand. And when you understand that you're a brand, then you got to deal with the business, because you got to control and operate as a business. We love to do the things that we do, but at the end of the day, it's a business. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And you got to protect your brand. A lot of people don't know how to protect their brand. A lot of people don't know how to go and get an LLC and open up a business account.
Right.
You know, some of these bands out here that's rocking and moving, they probably don't even have a business account.
Right.
Shouts out to Rapper Dude, too. Rapper Dude just tuned in. Hey, Rapper Dude, go to elitemedia.net, man.
And even even if you start a small step, you know what I'm saying? You gotta take a step at a time, and at a time to build your business up. Mm-hmm. And then if you got some bad apples that don't understand the business, because somebody not gonna understand, because people don't like change. But at the end of the day, you gotta develop your brand, and you gotta operate as a business. Yes, period.
Absolutely, absolutely. You know,
you have to operate as a
when you say it's all like family, you gotta make sure all participants fit your family. If they don't fit the family, it's not personal. It's just not working.
That's right.
I'm still gonna love you regardless. Right. It's just
that's
not
right.
Working.
It's a business. It's a business.
And then, and another thing I noticed too, sometimes you got people in your group that may work for a bank, or they may have accounting skills and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? You gotta utilize the skill set of people around you to help you too. Because sometimes we may get in our pride because we don't want to go ask somebody for help. Look, if I know you're an accountant, I can't do it. I'm gonna come to you and say, yo, brother, can you help me out with this? If I know you run sound or whatever you do.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Sometimes we gotta get out of our pride. Reach out to each other and say, look, this is what I need. This is what I'm trying to do. Can you help me?
Hey, Tommy, a big advancement in this industry would be what? If all brothers would learn to lose that ego. You get a bunch of brothers together, lose that ego, and seek out and get what you need. Ain't nothing wrong with asking somebody for something.
Yeah.
You know, information, things that you need to, there's nothing wrong with that.
Information
you
know, is
but as African American men that are predominantly in the go-go industry, you know, don't be standoffish about it. You know, you got to do what needs to be done.
Yep.
You know,
and it's about teamwork too, Juan.
Sure, absolutely.
Let's talk to KC a little bit here, man. Let me tell you a little bit about my brother right here. This brother
Praise God.
You know what, man? Hey, look. Anyway, this dude has been. He's a legend in the game. He's been doing this thing for decades. Been at the top of his game with EU, Class Band,
Trouble Funk.
He's done it all. Looking as dapper as he can ever look. Casey always dapper. Casey been dapper since when?
Yeah, since the Lion shirt.
Since the Lion shirt.
Yeah, the Tiger shirt.
Not the Tiger Johnson.
Tiger Johnson.
Put your hands together, man. Casey's in the build, man.
Hey, how you doing, man? Thank you, brother.
What's up, boy?
Hey, man.
Huh?
Trying to do it.
No, you're doing it, baby.
Trying to do
it. You're doing it.
And show May 7th, brother. Epic exclusive. Yeah. Fulfilled. Yes, sir. For KC and the band. Yes, sir.
So that's the name of the band, KC and the Band?
KC and the Band, brother. Gotta go off.
Without the sunshine, huh?
Without the sunshine, brother.
It's what you KC, what you got in store for the people, man? Talk to the people, man. Let them know what you got in store for them, man.
I got exclusive, you know, dynamite musicians, man. Dynamite musicians, you know.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Who you got in the roster, bro? Somebody we know?
Got Demi Doc playing keyboards.
Marquise
Owens. Marquise from Razz is on keyboards. You know what I'm saying?
Marquise playing?
We play jazz and R&B first. You know, we do Frank too. Rolos too. We give you some Rolos too.
Okay.
We give you that too because, you know, I played with Young Trouble and all that stuff. So.
Yeah, back in the day, Dave.
Shout out to RB, my man RB.
That's my son right there.
I ran two mics behind RB. I learned a lot from RB.
Yeah? Yeah. That's my little firecracker right there when I was managing Primetime, Slim.
Yeah.
Hey.
Yeah, that's my man.
Shouts out to RB and Chung Lee, my daughter and son, son.
I got Day Day Williams on drums. I don't know if you know Day Day.
Oh, Day Day, Day Day.
Young Mav Day Day.
Okay.
Day Day. Maya. Maya's singing with me.
Who?
And also, Maya. You sing with me with EU.
Okay,
Maya,
got
she
you.
She was going to be here tonight.
Got you. Okay. Who you going to go?
The Congo.
Yeah.
I got my man Kareem.
Ooh.
Kareem on the thing.
You don't lose with CPU. You don't lose CPU. The CPU.
Yeah, usually, you know, I had Congo Danny. That's my man. That's my walk, man. Usually, I got
Congo. That's the nephew right there.
I got the Congo.
That's my gentle giant right there.
Yeah, but I got Kareem doing this thing this time, you know.
Okay. Yeah. Well, you know, I got a roster of about 40 of them.
Yeah, I already know. I'll be seeing you get everybody be dying fit. I'm like, how the hell they fit in this one little room, huh, B? All 40 of them be sitting in Congo.
We a fraternity, bruh. We a fraternity, man. Every Congo player right now go. And the thing what we try to do is, like, you know, send an example. You know, everybody's just follow suit. We love each other, man.
Oh, yeah.
But at the same time, be like, I'm going to bust your ass tonight. You know that, right?
Yeah, you know. You know I'm going to bust your ass. You know I'm going to spank you tonight.
You know. But the thing about it, it's like growing up with your brothers, you know. You know, ain't nothing but brotherly love, man. I can't wait to hear you guys. I'm going to be at the show.
You definitely going to be there. I'm going to worry you and call you. Hey, man, we get ready. Here, we get ready. Here,
man, I'll be there, baby boy. You know me. That's all I love here, especially when somebody like you is putting a whole lot in the game.
Thank you, man. Yeah. Thank you, man.
You know, you deserve your rewards, time, man. And like I said, you got to be on stage like that. I need you like that.
Oh, yeah. That's what I do. I mean, some people joke me, but you got a full suit on. But yeah,
nah, that's right here. That's how Chuck was, baby. That's how Pop was. Yeah. Hey, Pop, we love you, man. And that's what it is. I love that name, too, KC and the Band.
KC and the Band. And the band. So I've been telling them the band got to be cranking.
Oh, man.
KC, the band got to be all the. And they are. I got a 3-man horn section.
Wow.
You going like that?
I got a 3-man horn section. Like it's the 80s.
Are you taking it back, huh?
I might do Freaky Deek and all types of good stuff. Yeah, I might do Valley Girl. Yeah, I might.
That's my thing. Ba-ba-da-da-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Good
come
God
on,
almighty.
Come on, boogie down with us.
Y'all heard the harmony, right? Y'all hear the harmony. See, back then, we all the same.
Yeah, everybody's song.
You know, now everybody, you know.
Yeah, you had to play something to be on the front line. You just couldn't play a tambourine.
For real.
I mean, all praise due to Allah. I mean, that's what the game is. It, you know, take your hats off to people that do that. But you be on the front line, you either the talker, the singer, or you play the horn.
Yeah, you just can't be up there hitting no cowbell.
I rap and I play the cowbell.
Nah, well, go ahead and buy a ticket.
Yeah, you go ahead and buy the drummer then. You stand right there by the drummer and do that. You ain't going to be up here.
8:10 p.m. y'all, each and every Tuesday, Mr. Hobby Conga, man. He like media that power by live music for you.com. Everybody's tuned in right now. Rapper dude is tuned in. Matter of fact, let me announce like I did it last
week.
That's
my man, rapper there.
Yeah, he looking at us right now.
All right.
I'm gonna tell y'all about the new Hall of Fame class we got. Let me let you guys know. I let the cat out the bag last week, okay? So the roster that's going in, and we also we're including the fan too. Okay, as far as the fan, it's Gogo Lando. Give him a round of applause. He's going in.
Gogo Lando. Well, you know he got going there.
I seen him yesterday, man. He came to my job, bro.
Lando, oh, my word God. That's my man. That's
okay.
My man, too.
Sugar Bear. Round of applause. He's going in.
Gregory Elliott.
Ow.
Shaggy.
Big G. He's going in.
G. He's going in.
32. Dave Ellis. He's going in.
Dave Ellis. Yeah. My man.
Chris Rappadude. He's going in.
The rapper.
Okay. And who else was going in, Tom? Who else? I forget.
that was it.
Yeah, that was it right there. So give them a round of applause, y'all. All them going. Yeah, man, Hobby Con, guys. Like I say, 10 p.m. each and every Tuesday, man. Everybody waves to the pub in Germany right now that's looking at us right now. But this is a ritual we do each and every week, man. We wait for Brandon Finley to call in. He just got off the stage in Munich, Germany. His birthday is today, too. So, oh, I'm sorry. You know what? I'm sorry. Donnell Floyd. That was the last one. I'm sorry. Donnell Floyd.
Floyd.
D. Floyd. I'm sorry. Donnell, please forgive me. I know you're probably cussing me out right now. Anyway, yeah, back to KC. KC, so let everybody know again, man, when y'all going to drop the bomb on them Bammers, man?
That's May 7th, man, at 7 o'clock every Sunday at Club Exclusives, brother. I wish I knew
give
the address.
What was that, Southeast, Northeast, Northwest, Southwest?
That's in Fordsville, Maryland.
Oh, Fordsville, okay.
They can Google it, or they can go to my website. You know, I got some funny name on my Facebook page, Abu Goy Fu.
I didn't know who the hell you were calling me the other day. Yeah. My damn messenger started ringing. That's going to say, Abdu Boo Foo Abu Wee. Who the hell is this?
Yeah,
look, then I put the thing, his face pop up. I'm like, this fool, man. Look at this fool, man.
Yeah, I got to put something. Yeah, brother. Before I had that, I put up there Mickey Tutu. I was calling myself Mickey Tutu, man, you know.
And like 3 weeks ago, man, they on Facebook talking about my brother, you know, deceased, right? So, yeah, tell them on you.
Oh, Mo called me 7 o'clock.
So I called Mo, right? I called Mo. Tell y'all called him?
No, he didn't tell me that.
No, I called. That's why he called you. That's why he called you.
Still living?
No.
Oh, you?
I called Mo because I panicked, right? Because everybody was chiming in to my RBKC and what the fuck? It was on Woody Woods' page.
Oh.
Then Mick was like, you know, you talking about KC from EU? Everybody like RB. I'm like, I'm looking at this shit like. Oh, hold on. First person I called, I couldn't talk to shop. So I called Mo. I said, Mo, what the fuck is going on, man? Because somebody would have called me.
Right.
Mo, what's up, Saudi? I said, man.
It was a Saudi.
Yeah. I said, man, what's up with Casey? Is Casey all right, man? These bambas on here talking about, you know, he passed away and all that. Mo was like, hold on, man, what? So Mo called you.
Right.
That's when he called me back. See, I just talked to him and said, phew. You know.
One thing about surprised myself, man.
Man, I
where
said,
did
dude,
that come from?
I don't know where that came from.
Stupid, mug. You know, I mean, first of all, something like that would happen. We've been all over the book anyway. Okay, so I'm like, what the? Anyway,
there's only two KCs and Go-Go.
That's it. You and Junkyard,
yeah,
and you,
Junkyard Kenny and me.
Yeah.
Only two.
So he's looking here, man. He's looking casket clean too, and he ain't in one. So you go figure, man.
That's right, bro.
You go figure, man. Ain't
hey, Mo called me 7 o'clock in the morning. Said, KC. Oh, good. I can go back to sleep now. He said, man, somebody on Facebook, man, doing that dumb stuff. Say you passed away. I said, oh man, I'm all right, brother.
Yeah, man. That's people love you, dumb, man. So we don't want to see nothing happen to you.
Hey, man,
I've been one of us. So
hey, it's good to be seen, not viewed.
How about that?
Believe that.
Huh? Mm-hmm. Well, in my case, good to be viewed. Hey, how y'all doing?
Viewed.
Yeah, that's what it is, man. We sitting here, man. We're going to let DJ Rick give us a little crank break and tap some of his Tito's.
Yeah.
Meantime, between time, man, tell a friend to tune in, man. Number one, show him Go-Go, man. I got it on my back like
hey,
a monkey, man.
240-455-5934-0.
We'll be right back after these messages on the number one show him Go-Go, man. I ain't say it. They did. It's Hobby Conga. Let's go.
Yeah. did this one here. Do something for the pure elegance, man, hey, y'all. We call this one here. We call it wet.
I like it wet, not dry. Give me a piece of the pie, sweet boo.
Come on.
your birthday, boy. Work with him. Work with him in your town. What you doing, Tanny?
Make it too, like a whistle, so cute, so fly. y'all can warm up a little bit. It's like it went and warm, y'all. Got some Redskin haters up top.
Yes, sir. Hold on. Let that marinate a little bit. Hold on. Give me some of that, Ron. I need this right here in my life. Nothing like a BYB pocket, man. Shouts out to Sauce Buggy, Big Z. Happy birthday, Weezy. Sweet thing, baby. How you doing? What you doing? Hold aside. Shouts out to Los. EB. Mike. Big Bob. Nate. Yes, sir. Earl. The whole damn squad, man. That's my BYB fan, man. Uptown's finest, you understand me?
Always be original,
yes, sir. Hold him, sir. That's the Uptown pocket right there, KC. That's the Uptown pocket right there.
Be original, man.
You hear me?
Always good to be original.
Not a 8 p.m. y'all, each and every Tuesday, man. It's a Hobby Conga app. Backyard in the back of the rear, marinating. Like some Lowry seasoning sauce, y'all. DJ Rick, you're a fool right now. You're an absolute fool right now, man. Now hold him, side. Not hold him sauce, but hold him, side. You never know, man. You got see, some people got smoke weed before they come in your show. That's why you got all these scavengers going to walk up in here. Got the weed up in their neck, man.
That's he who strikes first.
You don't stand me.
Strikes all the time.
Now watch they walk up in here smelling like a brute weed.
Right. That's all we gotta do.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You ain't drinking with me tonight.
We got the flying flashy that's walked up in here, ladies and gentlemen. We got the big picture up in here. We got Smokey the Legend up in here. And Ernest L. You will never see his eyeballs. Fresh from LA, off the boat. What it do, boy? All right, man. Hey, DJ Reception, off, man. 10 p.m. meeting number 2. It's Mr. Hubby Conga out, man. Subliminal criminal, give it the minimum, but depend on any direction type of dude, man. We're here riding shotgun with the one and only, KC, we live on the air, man. Etiquette, baby. Etiquette, baby. Let's resemble your suit right now. Etiquette.
Okay.
All right, baby. Hey, look. That's what it do, man. 8, 10 p.m. each and every Tuesday, man. So how the show on Go Hobby Conga out, man. DJ Rick on the ones and twos. Tommy Reed. Solar Entertainment is in the group. Right now, we got Dwayne Chapman in the group. And we got KC from KC and the band. The group looking like a Gillette razor sharp as a casket suit.
Thank you, man.
You don't stand me. So Tommy, before we get out of here, let everybody know what's up with Solar Entertainment, man. Like, again, shouts out to Cliff Jones. Happy birthday, big bro. But what y'all got, you know, for the future? Don't let the cat out the bag, man. We don't talk about that.
I can't do that, man.
Okay. We getting both getting in trouble.
Yeah.
But go ahead.
No, I mean, right now we just, we just got finished finishing up with the Braxtons.
Okay.
And you know, the production team was here in the DMV. We film a lot, you know, and we demand that they come here and film.
Okay.
You know. To just be here. Number one, Tracy lives here, Tracy right. Braxton, and she's from the DMV. So, you know, they got to come and represent the DMV too. So we shoot a lot here in the DMV. We're working on her album currently right now. I think she was recording tonight.
Okay.
So, you know, we got that going. Then we have a couple of other groups and acts that we're working on, because, you know, of course, we do a lot of development.
Okay, now, y'all have done BYB and Team Familiar after the Wizards game, okay? Y'all have done BBD after the Wizards game. Y'all have done Mama Sap, Seek and Find after the Wizards game, okay? Mm-hmm. Y'all just did DJ Kool the other night.
Mm-hmm.
Are y'all bringing any acts up there after the playoff games?
Well, excuse me. I mean, they probably.
Probably.
Probably. We just waiting to see. Just waiting for them to give us the go on it.
Okay.
So when they give us the go, I told Cliff I want to bring Go-Go in again. Just another teaser.
A teaser before the big hibachi.
Right. I mean, you know, I don't know how that's going to work, but, you know, it's just a suggestion. But, you know.
That's going to be crazy.
Yeah.
Like I said, man, I can't let the cat out the bag, but something that's going to be the biggest thing Go-Go's ever seen. It's right around the corner. Man, let me shut my mouth, man, because what these guys are doing, man.
We're going to announce it soon.
And man. I'm part of it. And the thing about it, I'm part of Soul World Entertainment, too. So.
Yeah, we're going to announce it soon.
That's what it is. And I don't want Big Papa. He probably watching right now. I don't want Big Papa, you know. Big Papa, I know you watching, man. Happy birthday, man. Happy birthday, Winksy, man. Shouts out to Winksy. Happy birthday, Brandon, man, who's in Munich, Germany. Just got off the stage. I talked to my brother from another man like 5 minutes before we went on stage. He heartbeat this. And I said, who's that in the background? He said, Red Hot Chili Peppers. We ready to come on after them. That's the big thing. You know what I'm saying? 75,000 people out there.
Wow.
And he let me hear the crowd. You know, that's my cloth, where I come from. That's what I'm used to rocking. Like 60, 70,000 people.
Well, I just saw the video the other day of you rocking the crowd the other day on YouTube.
Yeah, rocking like 70,000. Your boy Hobby.
That's crazy.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Doggy dog.
Yeah, doggy dog. That's why I be laughing when people say their shows are packed.
Man, it was so many people.
60,000.
Hey, like, it was packed last night, young. I be like, yeah.
As far
nigga,
as
that's, our, that's my dressing room, nigga.
400 people in there.
No. Shouts out to everybody, though, man. So, Tommy Reed, put y'all hands together one more time for the VP.
I appreciate it, man.
Love you, brother.
I appreciate it.
What's up, Bob?
And you know what? We really trying. Like, I commend you for keeping Go-Go alive.
Thank you, man.
From Richard World on back, we love you, baby. We love you, baby.
Thank you, baby.
I mean, if people had seen Metro World, then they would really get, they would understand.
Right.
Because you've been doing this dog a long time. This just ain't something you just started yesterday.
Yeah.
You've been doing this a long time.
And when he did it, wasn't nobody even thinking about doing this kind of stuff.
Nah. Remember, you was going to all the shows and filming live and doing interviews and live footage. A lot of people don't understand, dog. You've been doing this a long time, man. And I appreciate, even though I don't know all of the Go-Go legends, and, you know, Harpy teaches me a lot about them. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I've been to Go-Go since I was little, because Bones, my godbrother.
Bones 7th.
Class Anderson band. From Class Band.
Oh, Bones. Okay,
yeah, so he used to take me to he used to take me to the Go-Go's with him. You know what I'm saying?
I thought I remembered your faith.
Yeah, he used to tell me. You know, I was a young boy, but you know, he used to take me to the Go-Go's with him. But for you to sit back and acknowledge this genre with the legends of this game, of this genre, is so important, man, that these youngins understand who these gentlemen are, man. Because these guys are legends, man, in this. They created this, and they expanded this. And we got to bring it back to where it used to be.
Right.
And we got to bring it back to where these bands are doing original music. Original music.
Yes, sir.
That, for me, coming from a music industry standpoint, that's what I see. I want to see y'all start writing music.
That's right.
I want to see y'all start having your own publishing. That's what has to happen, man.
We need it.
That's what has to happen. So, you know, I commend you, dog.
Appreciate you, Tom.
I love you for it, man.
I love you back, baby. You know
and
that, man.
You know, and for anybody that want to hate on you or hate on this, they crazy. Because you've unified something that was almost dead, dog. No lie, man. It was almost dead, but you kept it alive, man. And I just want to commend you on it, dog.
Thanks, man. Wow. Wow. Trying to make me cry in here, man. Hallelujah.
Nah, man. We ain't doing that. We ain't doing that.
8:10 p.m., man. It's like 7 after the hour of 9 o'clock, man. Sitting here riding shotgun with the crew, man. And Tommy, I just want to let you guys know, man, thank you, you and Cliff, and you guys are so worthy. Thanks for all you're doing right now, you know. And I know y'all got my back 1,000,000,000%. So, yeah. But guys like you guys, my family behind me, I can't fail.
Yeah.
I can't fail. So one more time, man, Tommy Reed, so worthy, and the same building, man. He's in the building. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a 5-minute crank break because some guys just walked up in here along with my late-ass co-host. The world famous Go-Go Report, the number one blog in Go-Go. Ernest L's here. He finally got here. He been here, actually. I seen him outside. But, you know, he had to go get Chinese for a minute, though, so he good. But these other two guys just walked up in here, man. All I got to say to y'all is, you know, sometimes you got regular shit, but you look at KC's outfit, that's what you call quality. That's all I'm going to say. Crank them on that, man. Be right back in a minute.
That's right, y'all.
How you doing, Kim?
Hey, I appreciate the opportunity. Good stuff, man.
Guess who's on the
scene? I got the call, man.
Guess who's back,
y'all? My mom and Mars, man. I go to the Mars, man. I got to pay that phone call, man. I get fired by the ladies, you know? Anytime you want me to come down, come through or whatever, anytime.
You got to do that, y'all.
Love you too, baby. You know that.
I see you got to do that, too.
Sure, man. I'll be back to you.
I see you got a new attitude, girl. Hey, Aquarius, we're going to party with you tonight.
We're on a team.
My man Frankie Bird is celebrating his birthday. I see you, Frankie. How you feel, Rob? Oh, what you got now? Thursday night, 12 Lounge. Well, not a brand new spot, but a brand new situation.
Good to see you in the building while you watch.
Half of love is all I see.
Yes, it's about 17 after the hour of 9 p.m., y'all. Sitting here riding shotgun, my co-host Ernest L. just walked in, better late than never. Number one blog in Go-Go, the Go-Go Report. DJ Rick on the ones and twos, my main man Ron on the engineer. We just got off the facilities with my main man Tommy Reed, VP of Soul World Entertainment. Also, my man KC from KC and the Band. Also, Juan Chapman, thank you for the Tito's. We are sponsored tonight, y'all, by DeMarco Solar and Tito's Vodka. Just had to get it out the way. You two guys right here, before I introduce you, wave to the camera right now. It's a pub in Germany that watches us consistently each and every week. 60 people, 120-foot screen. Sitting here, man, I'm on Sean Gogo. That's the Hobby Kong guy, man. Each and every Tuesday night, 8 to 10 p.m. on elifemedia.net, powered by livemusicforyou.com. Shouts out to Rapper Dude and TT, everybody that's watching us live. Big G and everybody else. You know how we doing in D.C. Ain't no every. It's everybody else. Every. But without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, these two young, handsome gentlemen that's sitting to the left of me and to the right of me. And no homo, ain't no gay shit going on. These my brothers. Look, ain't nobody in my family ugly. So just let me start it off like this. Ladies and gentlemen, back in, I want to say, the 87, 88, 89 era, there was a band that frequented places like Evans Grill and the Pick Center. Out of Sea Pleasant, Maryland. Am I correct about that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You had bands, you know, back then like Quack Like a PC Groovers. you had. Don't you laugh at? Okay. Central Groove. Help me out, y'all.
Prophecy,
Pure Elegance,
Air Raid, Pure Elegance. I mean, that era back then, that was
Young Groovers.
I mean, but it was one band back then, man, that really captivated me, and I thought a lot of, and to me, was one of the most underrated bands ever. And it was a band called Quality. And what you guys don't know right now, and some of you do know, put your motherfucking hands together right now, because we got Tip Top Ty and Dirk here from the legendary Quality Band in the building right now. And they still live and kicking, and they back like they never left. Tip Top motherfucking Ty.
What's going on, Hot B?
Wow. Finally got you in the dungeon, baby.
Yes, sir.
And this dude right here, Tip Top Ty, you know, PC Groovers. Natural Soul, that's Grace Estate with a whole lot of legendary acts, man. One of the smoothest, dynamic ones to ever do it in go-go history. Bruh, before we start this interview, just let me commend you on your longevity, still having it, your smooth style, bruh. You never hated on anybody, was hated on by a lot of people, but you just continue to maintain your composure and keep that steadiness in that groove.
Right.
In that groove, man.
That's what's up, man.
Put your hands together. Tip Top Ty's in the build, man. Tip Top Ty. Where that name come from, bro?
Actually, my man Kevin Smalls made that name up.
Tip Top Ty.
Yeah. Tip
Top. And one thing about yourself, bro, that always enthused me about you is you had your own style, number one. Number two, you was always like, you was like a cross between Benny. No, I'm sorry. All the smooth dudes, like Funk, Psy, you were just a smooth dude, bruh. So, who did you look up to, as, you know?
Actually, Benny was my first, first rapper. Yeah, that's why I play trumpet.
Got you. Yeah. Yeah.
Benny was like my all-time favorite rapper.
And who was next after that?
Then after Benny, Funk grew on me because I felt like Funk was a better talker.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Benny was more like
a rapper.
Action guy. You know?
A sicer.
Yeah, sicer. They would say hype man.
Yeah.
You know, he put more emphasis in the grooves, you know.
Yeah.
But Funk.
So let's go. Let's start from day one in your history. What was the first band you started out with, Ty?
Well, actually, my first band was a junkyard band. It was called East Wind.
Wow.
Yeah. And then Mo and the Boys. From Mo and the Boys, I went to PC Groovers.
Could you quack like a duck? And quack, 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 quack.
PC Groovers, you know, that became the Class Groovers.
And you know I did that, right? I brung Earl to y'all.
Yeah.
Actually, I brung Earl to Class.
So you got Ty cut.
No.
You know what? We're going to get with you in a minute.
No. Actually, I didn't get cut. I knew the axe was coming out.
Right.
But Quality needed a rapper at the time. So that's how that Quality.
That's actually a movie. That's an actual movie because PC Groove was like Central Groove's rival.
Yeah,
they went from being our little brothers to like, oh shit, we got, hold on, these bammers, whoa, man. Yeah.
Right.
Greg started talking shit behind my back, like, yeah, I think I can get with Beat, man. I said, okay.
But at the time, Central Groove was a much better band.
Right.
With the showmanship and, all that. Yeah. You know, I'm going to be honest with you. Especially what you was doing back then.
Oh, man, and Pops ain't lost it, man. I still digging them young as ass, they tell you. CPU, man, I just spanked them a little bit one time or another. They'd be like, damn, Unc, what's with you? Anyway, so before we go to the next phase, let me get at this guy next to you, man. Now, back in the day, ladies and gentlemen, you know how you always got one smooth cat in the band? You know, pretty bama, you know, just try to look more pretty. And it's always a sax player, you know, because you always think about, na 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 na. And you know, it's in all the porn movies, it's always a saxophone in the music.
Yeah.
I don't watch a lot of porn. Ty do.
Whatever.
Yeah, right.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me say, man, this young man next to me, to my left and y'all right, looking at me on TV right now, has maintained the test of time because he don't look a day younger or a day older. He just look there, like he don't age. You know what I mean? This dude one of the smoothest cats I know, bruh. And when you say swag, it should be point.com behind his name. This dude has done a lot, and I know people in the DMV that's looking at the screen right now. Y'all know who this guy is, man. You know, I ain't gonna go through all his accolades. Everybody don't need to know his business. Because Bam was out here be desperate and trying to, you know, scheme ass Bamas and all that, man. And after the show, I'm going to ask one more time for $300. Anyway, man, put your hands together, man. The one and only, my main man, owner of Cranberries and just, you know, he's a positive influence on me. You know what I'm saying? Y'all want to be like somebody, man. Be like this dude right here. Put your hands together, man. Derek is in the motherfucking building, man. Quality, man. Saxophone extraordinaire.
Let me just say something before you go on, man. A lot of people don't realize Heartbeat and Rick, man, the foundation that you guys laid, and I mean that you're multi-talented, man. The Congos, and then the singing. It's like you sneak up on somebody, you know what I mean? They think they know you're one genre, and you pop out on another genre, man. So, you know, you guys, you know, even in the day, with some big shoes to fill, or just even try to stay in the same breath of what you guys did, man. You know what I mean?
So, wow, man.
Yeah, yeah,
wow.
Yeah. You and your brother, man. Absolutely.
Love is
absolutely.
Love, baby. I appreciate that, man. Absolutely. You know, we had a Joe Jackson household. You had the same, do everything in my household. So, you know, shouts out to Jose Williams Sr., you know, Big Papa, man.
Right, right.
But enough about that, man. And I appreciate that, man. Let's get to you, brother. Brother, I'm so proud of you, man. And all the endeavors and things that you have been able to accomplish, being a black man from one black man to another, I salute you, brother.
I appreciate that, man. But you know what, though? Let me say this, man. To me, the band is what I got to contribute to a lot of my management skills.
Okay.
Because at 16, 17 years old, trying to manage and do stuff like that kind of laid a foundation of management.
Right.
And I was just able to build on that. You know what I mean? So Go-Go really, to me, man, impact my life in so many ways. It's crazy, even to this day.
God is so good, man, because...
Yeah, full circle.
And for me to be able to travel to 76 countries throughout my journey, it's from Go-Go.
Right.
And people don't realize the significance that man right there had on all our lives, man. Papa, man.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's like Tommy was saying earlier, if we all actually come together as one conglomerate and just expand, we was outside talking earlier before we got what went on air about how much influence we done had on, like, multi-platinum hits.
Yeah.
And catapulted people like Salt and Pepper and Heavy D and Curtis Blow, Jill Scott. Like using all that, you know, Nicki.
Right.
Even Nelly, Kid and Play, yeah. Special Ed. And thank you, Ernest L. And we're going to take it back to that, though. We're going to take it back. Okay, enough of that, man. Let's talk about quality. Quality's back, man. What's going on with this, man? What made y'all come back to the fold? What happened? Tell me a story or something, baby.
You want to touch on that,
dude? When I walked into the studio that night when I was rehearsing with class. No, I'm sorry. All in, man. I said, is that Tyler there? Then I asked C, man. I said, man, what's going on? I said, who are we rehearsing next? He said, Quality. That's Zinto.
Oh, yeah.
Ain't none of y'all age, no. It's like y'all in a time machine or some shit, man. Y'all bammers are like Pick Center. I was waiting for Big Butch to walk in somehow. So what was the thing that triggered this whole movement? What's going on, man?
You know what? So a good friend of ours had passed away, Greg Hall, activist.
Oh, Greg, man. Right. Shouts out to Greg, man. Greg Hall, man. Yeah. Love Greg, man.
Man, we go
R.I.P. Greg, man.
Fairmont Heights, I mean, city activist. Really good, all around good dude.
Good dude, man. Good dude. Heart of gold, baby.
Real good dude, but knowing Greg, all, and it's the beauty about Quality, man. We all go back to when we was 14, 15 years old.
I know.
And we got 95% of the original members back.
That's crazy.
Right? That's crazy, right? That's crazy. 95 of them, right? So the thing was, when Greg passed, he used to always say, prior to him passing, that he wanted to see the band play one more time or get together and this, that, and the other. So when he did pass, someone real close to him said, hey, look, that was one of his wishes, and we want to do a benefit concert
for
drunk driving and things of that nature.
Yes, sir.
Would you guys be interested
in
getting together and doing a reunion show?
Yes, sir.
And they got in contact with our band leader, which is Courtney McKissick. He actually is the one who
who
put us all together.
Yes, sir.
And once we did that, man, we started getting more calls for more shows and more calls, and, you know, band was on the fence about it, but really we enjoyed being the camaraderie of seeing guys that you've known longer than you've known your kids.
Nothing like it.
You know what I mean? And this, you know, 20 years later, 25 years later, you guys have still got some common thread of what you do. And, you know, it's a beautiful thing, man.
Just, they can still do it.
Right, yeah.
Because I've seen a lot of jokers get back together, and you know, no offense. I'll keep it a buck, man. Y'all should have stayed.
Retired.
Yeah. Stayed in the basement, bro. Because a lot of times, you know, you got jokers coming out here. And I thank the Lord that I still got my gift.
Sure.
But I see a lot of cats, you know, that try to jump back out here. It's like, you know, a used car dealership, man.
Right. Yeah.
Used up, bro.
Yeah. You know? Yeah.
Cadillac Umbrella, all that, man. But that shit in the shop.
Right. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
The beauty with us, I think, that goes a long way, man, is, again, we got Lightfoot, Poochie. He's back on drums.
God Almighty.
There you go. You got Tony Champ, Congo, you know, one of the original Congo players.
That's my youngin' young.
He was 14 years old when he joined the band.
Yeah. I don't know how he owned one of the most historic videos ever.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
On that Go-Go documentary.
Yeah, the documentary, yeah. Coming with Tony. He's on my move.
Tony's on there.
There you go. Everybody had to steal a little something from the beat, right?
No. So, but one thing about Tony, though, guess what? He can straight out flat do it and still doing it.
Yeah, it is, man. The beauty, you know, we got Mike Timmons, you know, Courtney McKissick, Daryl Madden, Ty Randall.
Y'all don't realize these heavy hitters he's talking about.
Yeah, Cedric. We got, you know...
We got a female singer there that you're on the group.
Yeah.
Pooh?
Yeah, there you go.
Pooh?
Exactly.
Pooh. Straight. Hey, hold on. For y'all that don't know, Pooh, Slim. Not a game.
Yeah, she can do it.
She can straight. I can't wait to see y'all.
Yeah, Friday, man. Friday.
So this Friday coming up.
This Friday coming up, man.
I got to host a red carpet for this one joint. But as soon as I leave there,
come on down, man.
I'm coming on. Hey, Tom, we're going to have to get the limo to drop us off down there.
Oh, Hey, come on with it, baby. We can.
So we got me and Tommy. Me and Tommy got a Lambo Suburban junk coming to get us.
Okay.
I meant to tell Ernest L too.
I do it big boy style right here.
No, we're trying to do a Dirk style. No. So we're going to leave that go down there with y'all. Y'all in the sweat, man. So,
yeah,
and Rick, you're you welcome too to come. Ron, you can come too, man. Everybody, Smokey involved too. But I don't know how Smokey. Smokey just got back from L.A. And, you know, he think he cute. Man, I'm just joking with you, man. Good God. You ain't learned your little brother by now?
I know.
Good God of mine. We're going to get you up here in a minute, too. I got to holler at you about some things on this mic because everybody ain't seen your age. Where'd Bones go? I thought Bones was up in here.
Oh, Bones had to go pick his daughter up.
Oh, okay. Well, the big picture, if you listen to me, I love you, man. Yeah, getting back to quality. So what can the people expect from you? Let's talk about the tag team now. Y'all done teamed back up with High Cold Sweat.
Oh, man.
And this reminds me so much like the Evan Grill days.
This was the collar.
The Pick Center days, man.
This was the collar.
And I get chills just talking about this because that's when Go-Go was Go-Go. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
With the old man taking the pictures. Remember that?
Yeah.
With the psychedelic background.
There you go, right?
But let's talk about this card, man. What's going on, man? Tell me about let's excite the people a little bit.
You know what, man? This is an exciting card, man, because everybody know one of the most dynamic Congo players for showmanship.
Rock.
Oh, my goodness. Rock Steady. Do y'all want to see the Rocket Dance and all of that good stuff?
That's right? The brother. Hall of Famer. Hold on. You got to say this now. Hall of Famer Rock Steady.
Hall of Famer Rock. Give it to the Rocket. I mean, back in the day, the combination used to be a lot of quality and sweat. And, I mean, we did Annapolis, all over the city.
Yeah.
Charlie Fenwick, Butch, they used to put together really good shows. So when we had an opportunity to be down Touche's this Friday, I reached out to Rick. And, you know, he was more than accommodating and said, man, we can do it. We can make this happen. Short notice show. That's why it's completely free all night. But for anybody who liked old school go-go, who enjoyed just good music and having a good time, you getting Slick Rick, you getting
Tip Top Ty.
Tip Top Ty, you getting Tony, you getting Pooh, you getting Heartbeat, you getting Court, you getting everything all for free.
Talk
all
that
night.
Shit.
All night. All night. And Touche's on 12th and H. So y'all can come on out, man. You can have a good time. They got bottle specials, table specials. It's going to be a grown and sexy crowd. It ain't going to be no sausage festival. It's going to be some women up in
That's
there.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Big fat funky jumps up in that gym.
Exactly.
Bubble butts.
There you go. There you have it.
BB.com.
That's what you like?
I love a bubble butt affair.
That's what we're going to plan to have, right?
So Ernest, what's up, Ernest? You going to bring the Go-Go Report down there or what? All
right, man. It's on.
Huh? What we going to do? What we going to do, E? You know, that's the helicopter right there.
There it is.
He do like six, seven go-go's a night.
Let's show the youngins what the old school about, man.
Yes, sir.
And if anybody can pull it off, and bring it to him, that dude right there, Slim.
Oh, yeah.
He be at like six, seven go-go's a night, Slim. You might see him there, then pop up somewhere else, then pop up. How the hell is that? You know, that's how he do, though, man. You know.
That's good. That's what it's about.
That's the co-host, man, Ernest L., man.
Yeah,
that's what's
up. You know, that's the man right there. 8:10 p.m. each and every Tuesday, man, sitting here riding shotgun with Quality, my man Big Derek, and my main man Tip Top Top, the legendary Quality, man. They going to be down. Let them know again about the show, man. Let everybody know what's happening, man.
This Friday night.
Friday night, down, man. Stop playing, man. What's wrong with y'all?
Do their thing. We're going to have a fabulous time. We got the Sweat Band that's going to be there, formerly High Cold Sweat. You got Quality Band that's going to be there.
Talk your shit.
95%. The original band is right.
Talk your shit, Knuckle.
We're going to be there. We're going to tear the house down.
Let them know.
All of Fairmont Heights, Largo, Central High Schools.
God, oh my.
All of y'all from what was that, 87 to 90-something.
The Bubble Park, Butt Honey
Capitol
will
Heights,
be in the building.
Capitol Heights, Kitland,
Capitol Heights, the original you hear me, Rick? 2-5-hour store. I know y'all probably old.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Huh? Whoa, 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 whoa. Moonwalk, Michael Jackson. Back up. The Who Hour Store?
It was the 2-5.
Stop playing with me, man. Not the Sugar Shack Crew.
Yeah, Sugar Shack Crew. We used to have the Sea Pleasant Crew. Everybody used
man.
To be coming
up. Let's hear the land of Keisha the World.
Keisha the World. Let's
hear
was
the mad at me when I took Keisha, boy. I had whole Sea Pleasant mad at me.
There you go, right? You took
Keisha
the
World.
The Queen of the Ghetto.
That was my baby right there.
There you have it. Keisha the World.
Man, hey, look. Hey. Everybody, look. We live on the air, but we also live on Facebook. Who that right there? Let me see. You know that Tony Champ, Gracie. Damn, you got the whole. What's up, Champ? What's up, Tom? Is that Tom?
Yeah,
that's Tom. What's up, little bruh?
Let me see, D.
He gonna slap shit out from Congo too. Look, that's the prettiest Congo player ever, right there. Pretty Rico, what they call him. I ain't playing. That's the prettiest Congo player ever. Rock City think he the prettiest. Nah, Tone's the prettiest. Besides Smokey though, I don't know. They got a tough one. Yeah. But any last parting words before we get off the air, man? Y'all must have some shouts out. So
Shout out to the whole city, man. Listen, you guys got to support this radio station, man. This gives a venue for a lot of these bands, a lot of people to just explain what they're doing, what's going on, man. Anything we can do to support Hot Beat and his dream and what he's doing every Tuesday coming in here, keeping this thing rocking and rolling and watching this thing just grow into what it is right now.
Thank you, man.
It's a positive move.
Appreciate
and whatever we can do to support it. But we're going to be doing some more old school stuff.
Man, I can't
class,
wait.
With just a lot of bands that we would like to see again.
Yeah.
And just want to see how everybody sound. And just to see some of the folks we ain't seen since high school. You know what I mean? So we're going to be putting some stuff together. So y'all stay tuned and continue to support my man Heartbeat, what he does, and Quality Band. We're going to be down Touches Friday. Y'all come check us out with the Sweat Band.
Hold on. And this was, guess who just walked in the door?
Who's that?
There he just walked in the door. Look. My brother from the same mother.
There you have it, right?
Come on in here, Rick. A nice segue to what we've been talking about, man.
And
he always, but the thing about him, though, each and every week, that's how he walks in.
There it is, right? He's a superstar. Ain't nothing changing.
Yes,
only difference is he ain't got his black trench coat on. No,
that's what it is.
Back in the day, he had that black.
Oh, you mean the picture? Oh,
yeah. Y'all got the trench coat on.
We like what they're saying. We're going to start saying, cooling me out. Cooling out. Oh, he cooling me out.
Exactly.
What's up? What's up, Slick Daddy? What's up, baby brother?
Ain't a damn thing up, man. I'm just chilling like a villain, holding on, you know, trying to maintain. I can't kill nothing, won't die, but I'm gonna keep on pushing.
See, that's what I'm talking about. See, everything he just said right there,
huh?
It's just smooth.
Oh my God!
He didn't mean to say that shit, but it just came out.
Oh my goodness!
Hey.
What's happening, man?
What's up with y'all lead rappers, man? Y'all gotta say some slick shit.
What's happening? That's man. Hey, you know these are my dudes,
kill,
man.
Can't kill none, won't die, and all that bullshit.
But these my dudes, man. For years.
Hey Rick, you know what?
Years. I ain't talking about no 5-10 years. We go back.
Yeah, decades.
You know,
decades, man, and.
When we actually first started in this thing.
Yeah.
Ty know what's up.
Yes, sir.
Quack like a duck. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Quack, 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 quack.
Exactly.
Could you bark like a dog?
We damn near started around the same time, ain't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Y'all came in there, came in Evans Grill with them big old bass cabinets. Roadies and everything.
Yeah.
Blue jumpsuits.
Yeah.
Earth thing coordinated.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we had coordinated.
But let me tell you something, though, man. Y'all, the showmanship, that was hard to follow.
Yeah.
Between, I don't know what was worse, but it was you and Rick, and then when it became Heartbeat and Rick. And like, damn, Rick played shit out of tambourine, too. Like, oh, I said,
man,
damn.
You know what, man?
We got to do some steps or something. We got to keep up with these dudes.
No, what it was with us, man. Rick will tell you, we practice every day after school.
Well, it showed, man.
Every
showed.
Day.
It showed.
Yeah, we practice every day, man.
Well, yeah, it was every day, wasn't it, bro?
We look forward to practicing.
Yeah.
This shit was
nowadays,
crazy,
you can't get none of these old dudes to practice.
Johnny Gill outside with a jerry curl.
You got too many prima donnas and male divas out here now, so, you know.
Yeah.
But I don't understand how you're a male diva and you broke.
There you have it, right?
You know what I'm saying? They out here, though.
They right. out here. All
yeah,
day.
I'm like, man, come on, man.
Hey.
8:10 p.m. each and every Tuesday, man. Hobby Kong, man, sitting here riding shotgun. The legendary, my brother Slick Rick just walked up in here, man. We talking about that card going out Friday with the legendary Sweat Band and Quality. This like I told him, like a pick center up there.
Yeah, most definitely.
Evans Grill.
Most definitely.
All we need is Big Butch.
Yeah, most definitely. Yeah, and Quality, man. I'm gonna tell you. I know Ty been doing this thing, and Derek been talking about putting it together. But you know what? When I walked in at y'all rehearsal, when I seen Tony, that's what I said, oh, they official.
Then
yeah.
you didn't do it.
Yeah.
It is
official.
Yeah.
And Tony, and still
I look
the same.
Tony, oh my, probably sister pick center.
Yeah, you know, that's so crazy. Like, Tony disappeared on us, right? And so Courtney had been talking about putting something together, and it was, you know, some underlying stuff. And then Tony just called me up and said, D, what you going to do, man? You in or you out? I said, well, I'm in. You in, I'm in. We in.
Yeah.
He said, well, just call me when the showtime is. I said, nigga, you ain't play no combos in 20 years. What about some rehearsing or something?
Right.
So, I mean, you know, the beauty of the band, man, I ain't even going to lie to you, man. I look forward to just camaraderie. You know, the chemistry of the guys.
Nothing like it, man.
That, right. You know, it's just like family. You know what I mean?
Right,
he said,
right.
You know, he be on his period sometimes, but we got to slap him around. But other than that, man,
and you know what, though?
It's like family, man. You
like
know,
last... Man. Last Wednesday, it was Hawk, our drummer's birthday.
Okay.
Now, Levi's, y'all might have seen it on Facebook.
Yeah.
And, you know, they called me up there. And here come Rick. And Rick called Jock up there.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
It was magical, dog.
Yeah. Yeah.
And a lot of cats, you know.
Yeah, that jump locked like old times.
A lot of the cats, after the show, they're like, damn, B, y'all niggas, damn. It's like,
yeah.
You know. They froze y'all or something.
Yeah.
Like you said, camaraderie. Like, it's the same thing with Central Groove, bro.
Yeah, man.
And
that's what
it comes to the point where Mickey was like, you know, y'all got to do another reunion, dog.
Yeah. You know what it is, man? This is the thing that I think, as a society, everybody's moving to. We starting to appreciate what we used to have.
When you
look at old school cars and stuff like that, we go back and now, you spend more money on it. 1970 car than you would on a 2017
yeah.
car.
Mm-hmm.
So now we recognize the quality of music that we was playing back then.
Right.
And so now it's kind of have a resurgence. And I think, you know, to be quite honest, man, when I seen the success that Sweat had, and they stayed at it. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
they did some announcements and things like
Rick,
that. And I'm like,
whoa.
Man, them niggas still together.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so it's like, you know, that said, hey, man, we could probably do something
same
for
thing.
Everybody
yeah.
in there, you know. So I just appreciate the opportunity to be on the stage again, to share the stage with, you know, a cat like Rick that, you know, we all used to love to see him perform, do his thing. Him and Heartbeat, the rest of the band, what was your drummer name?
Jimmy Jam.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Just bring back memories, man. Charlie
right.
Fenwick, the whole. And I think, really, we probably would have kept it going if we wasn't so. Our pride got in the way when Pleasure came out. They wanted us to open up for Pleasure.
Yeah.
We opened up for them girls.
Right.
Hell with that. We quality.
But you know what? That happened to all of us.
Yeah, it did.
I think Charlie's focus was on Pleasure.
Yeah. I mean, it was what it was. It was an evolution.
Yeah.
It was new.
Exactly.
And that's what it was. It's just we wasn't ready for the change, but guess what? Society was.
Right.
So, I mean, it is what it is. So we live and we learn.
Right.
That's what it is, man. Sitting here with the legendary Quality Man, also Slick Rick from the legendary Sweat Man, formerly known as High Coast Sweat. It's now approaching 15 of the hour. Harvey Conga each and every Tuesday at 10 p.m. on ElikeMedia.net network, powered by LiveMusicForYou.com. And sitting here, they talking about this endeavor that's going down on Friday at the where?
Touche Live.
What time? What time?
9 to 3.
And the Bubble Butt Honeys will be in the
it's
field.
It's free all
yes,
night.
Sir.
You get to see the superstar himself, Slick Rick, in the
man,
building.
Don't do that, man. Don't
you bringing your trench, Rick. And Rick bring that trench out.
What?
You got to bring the trench out.
Medium now. Medium jump.
You gonna still squeeze it too.
Split the back.
Might be a church coat, man.
That's gonna
turn into a vest now, young.
Yeah, you have it.
Yeah, old school joint.
That is.
So, Rick, what can the people expect from Sweat Man?
Oh man, they can expect
Whoa.
Oh, we gonna get that all day. But
the Matrix.
Whoa, the Matrix, and like I say, we growing and sexy, but we got a different type of crank.
Yeah.
We growing and sexy, and we high energy. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah.
We high energy. That's why
female.
I tell.
You know what? You know what's gonna be so interesting about that night? Because y'all got Pooh, right?
Yeah.
They got Cody, right? Those probably the most two slept on females in Go-Go.
Oh yeah.
Right.
Yeah, a lot of people
because,
don't know. Because
Pooh gets straight.
Tommy Boys.
Do it.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And Cody got the fluid.
There it is.
So together.
All you gotta do is put.
They just
back
like
it.
Nike. Just
right.
Do it.
and think about it. The thing about it, a lot of people don't realize these girls that we're speaking of, I don't know if Pooh ever talk to y'all about it, but they get start feeling a certain kind of way when you label people as go-go singers.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Like Cody, Cody is not a go-go singer. Cody is a flat-out singer.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, when she sings at all.
Yeah.
That, and a lot of people are like, oh, you sing go-go. You sing, what the hell is singing go-go?
Right, right.
If you can sing, you can sing.
Right.
Now, if you want to be, I mean, truth be told, a lot of people that's labeled as go-go singers are actually tone deaf.
Yeah.
They tone deaf.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, if you consider yourself a go-go singer, you might want to think about it a little bit and revamp your mindset. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Those two females right there, man, that's to me, those two, like, yeah.
And they can go.
Both of them.
Oh, absolutely.
And I'm not just saying that being biased, they can go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
But we're going to have a good time Friday night, man. You know, I plan on having the fun, partying, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I might drink a little bit.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
You know, freak a little bit.
Freak a little bit. Smoke a little bit. Drink a little bit.
I ain't going to smoke a little bit. I'll do some edibles if they got some of them jump out.
You better talk to Ernest L about that one. I don't know.
Hey, look. Give us the Rice Krispie treats or something.
Hey, you had it, right?
That's what it is, man. 8 to 7 p.m. Each and every Tuesday, Hobby Con Guy. Approaching 10 of 10. We had a nice time this evening, ladies and gentlemen. I want to thank everybody for chiming in and just coming. I was supposed to call Brandon. He's in Germany. Let me see if I can get him on the phone, man. His birthday today. So he's supposed to call in. He probably got one of them international situations.
They're playing tonight?
Yeah, they just got the stage.
It was like daytime over there.
No, it's 2 a.m. now, approaching 2 a.m. They're in Munich right now, Munich, Germany. And, my brother from another man, Brandon Finley's on tour right now. I had to shut it down. I couldn't do it no more, man. Kids, Murray, tired.
Yeah.
You know, to talk to, But shout out to the baby boy. He's still doing it, man. So, Slick Rick, where's Rocksteady at the moment? Where's he at? Well,
he said he was gonna try to make it tonight, but more than likely he probably wouldn't be able to make it, cause he was busy doing something. I don't know. Rock could be.
That's my brother from another.
Anywhere right doing whatever, taking care of business, or he might be sleep somewhere. He goes to sleep quick.
Did y'all know that him and Mickey is cousins?
I never knew that.
Rock
they didn't
sleep
even. They didn't know even.
No. Yeah, Rock mess around. Rock mess around. Fall asleep in interview.
Yeah, that's how he do. But yeah, man, that's what it is, Hobby Con Guy. Next week, let everybody know we're going live down to Runner Lab with West Mob. We're doing a live broadcast.
When's that? Next week?
Next week, next Tuesday.
Oh, okay.
No, they next Tuesday. So they
they got a whole lot of what they doing down Runner Lab? It's a whole lot of stuff jumping off down there.
Something down there tonight.
Well,
is it
West Mob down there tonight?
No, they next Tuesday, bro.
I thought it was you.
Next Tuesday.
They won't let me in that joint.
Yeah, y'all might.
Tear the house down.
That would be my aim, too. Down. Tear that damn thing down.
Yes, sir.
We're on the live.
Yeah. And,
I'm just trying to get a check.
And you got Tony. I mean, they got like regular bands that be down there, like, Googie the House, man. House, do the House. And they got Trouble Funk going back down there.
We did Trouble.
Let me see if I can get this one in line, man.
They had Dynasty down there.
Dynasty?
Yeah. Top five Dynasty.
Not Dynasty from back in the day, Dynasty?
Yeah.
Yeah. They were just recently down there a couple of weeks ago.
See if I can get this boy on the line. It's just
I need that plug. Who got the plug from Runner Live? Call me.
I can see what's up.
So I got a whole lot of Baltimore folks that want to come see me do my thing, and they ain't trying to come into the city.
That's a different European type one. Listen.
You probably call it a fax machine. That's what that sound like.
Benny Hill and shit.
Yeah, Benny Hill.
Exactly. We all used to stay up late watch that joint. Only porno you can see. Well, Eddie Hill.
No, Super TV.
Yeah, I was about to say.
Scramble Jones.
Yeah, that joke go to scramble mode. And I be trying to unscramble that joke. You squint and try to look at
the joke. I see a titty or something.
Oh, I see a nipple in there. You know what I'm saying?
Anyway, man, let's go around the table, man. Let's get some shout outs, man, before we get off the air, man. Go ahead and start with you, Slick Daddy.
Well, I'm going to shout out the whole sweat band, the ones who couldn't be here. Well, that's everybody except for me. Shout out to the Humpies, Congo. Also, Tommy. What's up, Tommy?
What's up, man?
Yeah, Tommy, with my tracks you promised me about a month ago, man. I'm going to call you out, too. And also...
Well, let's get my man over here real quick.
Come here, Smoke. Ernest L. From the Go-Go Report. That's my man.
The world famous.
Hey, I was watching that joint you did. You put up there from Wisdom Matter Woman, E. Man, terrible joint. Shout out to the Quality Band, man. Good to see him back doing their thing.
Yes.
So my man Tip Top Ty. Yes. Doing back on the map. All right. Let's back don't back disappear no more.
Y'all know what that is, right?
Yeah.
Do your thing. Also, Dirt. Dirt. Hey, y'all don't know. Dirt still you blowing that horn, too.
Well, try to.
Hey, you know what that is?
Man, you can blow it, man. Yeah. Ty, you blow it. Hey, Dirt, you blow that joint, Dirt. Right, Ty, you still play trumpet?
He just left home practice.
Oh, you still playing too? Go ahead. That's what I'm talking about.
What you got?
Thanks to Mr. D.
Yeah, he pulled you back up on it.
Pick that horn up. Pick that horn
yeah,
up.
Yeah, don't put it down.
Okay, he can't put no more people on the front line, so pick that horn back up.
There you go.
There you go, right?
Yeah.
That's what's happening. That's what's happening. Tip top. What you got to say, man?
That remind me of Hunter Vernon and Young Boy Lee.
I want to send a shout out to the whole Quality Band. Special shout out going to my man Courtney, the founder of the band, you know, because through it all, he kept us together, you know, and also all the new members, Malcolm, our new bass player, Pooh, the new singer, she do her thing, you know, so I want to just send it out to Tony and all the rest of the players. Who? Oh, yeah, we got a new league guitar player, Wayne. I want to send a shout out to my man Wayne.
Okay.
He came from Backyard, the original Backyard.
Okay.
You know, back in the day with that first league of top player.
Okay. You know,
that's about it for me.
All right, man. What's up? What's up, Pretty D? What's going on, man?
I can get used to these new nicknames.
Oh, D got diamonds and shit. Hold up, D. What you doing? I see diamonds on the wrist, diamonds on the neck.
I'm just chilling. I'm just
lying.
What you pushing out there, man? What kind of car you pushing out there?
Hey, B, don't it? Hey, guess what? I'm going to throw this out. Let me say this. One thing I'm going to say about that Quality Band. I challenge any man out here to fuck with them in the parking lot. Swim. And it's real. I pulled up to practice. I thought it was a European car lot. I'm like, what the hell? Man, everybody pushing good.
Bentleys and everything.
You got Porsches, Beamers, Audis. Yeah, they going straight European. And I'm pulling up in the damn American Denali. Look, rock to my man. I got to get me. Let me pull my junk beside them jumps. They ain't gonna leave me out. Yeah, but they fly. They mean with it.
That's what I'm talking about. What's the name of the band?
Quality.
What is the name?
High Quality.
There you go.
All they drive is quality. Yeah, quality vehicles.
Put up on no 10 speed. Fuck with
them. They ain't play. Ain't nobody getting off the metro.
It is.
Go ahead, Pretty D. What's happening?
Man, listen, a special shout out to the whole band, man. If we forgot you, then we apologize. But most importantly, man, I want to see all of Fema Heights, all of Largo, all of C Pleasant, all of 2-5. Well, I don't know about 2-5, but all of y'all that can make it, that you know, that they can come down here, man, you're going to have an opportunity to see guys do what y'all used to see and do back in the day. You're going to feel like it was a good old go-go, but ain't going to be crazy in there. You're going to have the sweat band. You're going to have the Quality Band. You're going to get a good, nice, exciting night of a really good time.
And it's free.
And it's absolutely free. Absolutely.
On a Friday night?
On a Friday night.
We're going to pump this thing.
Bring your girlfriends down. Say it's your birthday. I don't care what you do. Get yourself a table. They got bomb food. I don't know if you guys used to mess with us when I used to own Cranberries. But Touche's got one of my chefs down there. So if you enjoyed the food at Cranberries.
See, hold on. Stop right there. See.
Y'all can get some of that same good food down
there. You know what I'm saying?
When
I used to, you know, got my chef.
So, yeah, y'all going to have a great time. And I think Black Mike going to be there, live and in person.
Forget about Lightfoot.
The lights. There you have it, man. I'm excited.
Man, I want to say to both of y'all, man, Sweat Band and Quality, I love, I mean, of course I love my brother.
Absolutely.
But I love y'all too, man. And you know. Just, you know, to see you guys come back in a big way like you are,
yeah.
It makes my heart feel good. And one thing I want to do too, you know, is, you know, with the old school thing, let's create our own circuit.
Yeah.
Because, you know, it's it's a space for that right now.
Absolutely it is.
And old school bands battle, man.
You know, we always want somebody battle.
Finally against Westmont, Magic Station, man. Friendly battle, you know.
It's a friendly battle.
And before we get off the air, look. Okay, y'all. Before we get off the air, my man ain't been here in a minute. He just got back from L.A., but put your hands together, y'all, for the legendary Congo player, Smokey from E.U.
All right, Smoke.
What's up, fellas?
Right.
And
what's up, Smoke?
A lot of y'all guys don't know. He is the dad of one of the most, one of the hottest rappers out here right now, who goes by the name of Logic. That's his dad right there.
Okay.
So,
Yeah, man. Sorry I wasn't here. I missed a lot, man. You know, Mickey's birthday.
Yeah.
You know, a whole lot of things. But at the same time, I gained a lot of knowledge by going out west, right?
Right.
And the bottom line is, I can proudly say I am a part of the Visionary Music Group family.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. You're okay.
Yeah.
Right.
So, right at this point in time, we're working on my project.
Okay.
That's why I was out there doing some things. And, they're going to be ready for this sound that's coming out there, because I'm bringing a little bit of this out there. So,
that's what's happening.
You know what I'm saying?
So you in the front? You in the mic?
I'm just doing what I do, man.
Okay.
Singing, writing, playing percussion.
Y'all know Smokey, man. Smokey, see, y'all got to realize something. One for Smokey wouldn't be no hobby, wouldn't be no Mickey, wouldn't be no a whole lot. It was all, back then it was Smokey and Jungle Boogie.
Right.
Those are the rivals.
Yeah.
Okay? And I'm just so happy to, you know, to call each one of those guys, my brother, my big brother. And Smoke, we got to, when you going back to L.A.?
Well, right now, man, Bobby's album is getting ready to drop on May 5th.
Logic's album.
No, Logic.
To us. Bobby. Yeah, that's your son.
My name.
Junior. Yeah, your Junior.
Yeah, but his album's going to drop, as a matter of fact, May 5th, the same day that Kendrick Lamar's dropping.
Yeah, my daughter's birthday.
And the name of his album is called Everybody. Which is, I'm gonna tell you, when I was out there, I went out to Warner Brothers studio, and I had a great time at Warner Brothers, and I got to see my son direct the orchestra, because he's got like orchestra on like five of his cuts on his album. So, you know, and I enjoyed it.
And your son was called by Jay-Z the most lyrical MC out right now.
Yeah, well, you know, he do what he do.
Well, he signed a Def Jam, right?
He signed to Def Jam as an independent.
Okay.
So basically, only thing Def Jam does is distribution for him.
Gotcha.
You know.
And he has a cult following. This dude has a cult following.
Well, you know, the kids, man, he relates to people in general, because he talks about the life that he lived and what he's gone through to get to where he's gotten today.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and he's a good person.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the most important thing, is to be a good person
mm-hmm.
in this business anyway. Because if you treat somebody bad in this business and you're going to the top, believe me, those same people that you treated bad, you're going to find them going down.
You sure about that?
You know, and I haven't been active that much, but yeah, I'm trying to get some features with some people. So Quality Band, give me some features, baby.
Definitely.
You know, Heartbeat, you know. Just doing, man. Trying to do it.
Well, Smoke, man, we you know I love you. I ain't got to tell you that. And, you know, you're part of the Hobby Con guy anyway. You've been here numerous times. You always support. We did a birthday party for him down there, down Nipsey's, man. We had a good time down there. And, you know, one thing about CPU, we love each other, man. And we come out and support. And Smokey and Jungle Boogie, you know, Loose Booty was out here earlier, back in the day, man. We just
Loose Booty.
He was out there. Loose Booty.
That just ain't a song. It's
no, it's the Congo player.
Congo
Peacemaker. Peacemaker. Loose Booty.
Yeah, yeah. I was like, it was Loose Booty. Heard. You picked out the name.
Let me tell you, Booty, right? And I'm gonna tell you something about Booty real quick. We used to call him Binky. Right?
Okay.
And he was my rubber. He set up my equipment, right?
Right.
That boy learned a lot.
We all did.
All of y'all.
We all did.
All of y'all.
That's you on, you know, Sugar, Sugar Ray. Knock him out, knock him out. Sugar, Sugar Ray.
They still call him Loose Booty to Danny.
Yeah, Loose Booty.
Damn, he need to go with a name change.
Yeah. You know what? And Booty probably, hey, Booty, that's pretty deep, man. So.
No, I'm just saying. I don't know who is.
Matter of fact, he in there right now. He's in here.
Let me try to leave here one piece that I don't want.
He in here. And that's Peace Maker's manager right there.
Loose Booty, I'm going to tell you why. Nah, I'm good.
Look, man, we see y'all next week now from Run Alive. We're going to do the live broadcast. Well, look, you got the Sweatman quality here. The legendary Smokey.
Shout out.
Hey, Smokey.
Yes, sir.
I got a surprise for you, too, coming up, man. Somebody keep putting the light off or something.
Man, I keep hitting
it. That's what it is, man. Look, meantime, 20 times to Hobby Conga. I each and every Tuesday night, man, 8:10 p.m. on elitemedia.net. Powered by Live Music for You. That's what it is, man. I'd like to thank all our guests that came through tonight, Tommy Reese, so we're entertaining. We had KC from KC and the Man come through. We also had Juan Chapman, bought the Tito's, a surprise everybody with a half gallon of Tito's. We got the Quality Band in here. We
did
got
you,
Sweat Band came through.
Did you get
through.
Go-Go?
Huh?
Totally.
Interrupted his announcements.
No, that's fine, man. Ain't that, man. They know how we do it. But thank everybody for tuning in, man. Rod the Rapper, you know, Chris Black, everybody, Genghis. We can see everybody tuned in, man. We appreciate y'all. We love y'all, man. Thanks for tuning in there. Each and every week, man, on Hobby Con Guy, man. That's what it is, man. We see y'all next week from the Merlin Lab with the West Mob. And until then, man, keep God first. We love y'all. I'm gone. Peace.
Absolutely. This